Hi, I'm Prashanth. I belong to Physics Department of Bharata College. Today we are going to discuss about the topic polarization. We all know that light is electromagnetic wave. That means electric field vector and magnetic field vectors are perpendicular to each other, and that will perpendicular to the direction of propagation of the wave. And also we know that the light waves have dual nature, that is particle nature and wave nature. The wave nature of light was established from the theory of interferences and diffraction. But this theory does not tell us the nature of the wave, that is longitudinal or translational waves. So the polarization, that gives the detailed idea about the translational motion of the wave. Okay, consider an ordinary light, that's light from an incandescent bulb or from sunlight or even from the candlelight. We can see that the vibration of the particles are in all directions. So in the figure, it is clear that the vibrations are in all directions. So these lights are known as unpolarized light. When the vibration of the light, which are confined along a particular line or a particular plane, it is known as polarized light. The process of converting the unpolarized light to polarized light is known as polarization. Now let us consider a mechanical experiment to demonstrate the polarization. So the experimental setup is as shown in the figure. It needs a string and two slits S1 and S2. Okay. So the string is passes through the slit S1 and S2, and the one end of the slit is fixed at the point B and the other end is free to move. The other end A, if we move the other end in such a manner that ups and downs, a translational motions or the translational vibrations are occurring in the string. And these translational vibrations are passes through the slit S1 and it will reach the slit S2 and it will pass through and finally it reaches at the end B. So these vibrations will pass only if the two slits S1 and S2 are parallel to the vibration of the plane. Okay. Now let us consider if the slit S1 is fixed and the slit S2 is moved, that is slit S2 is rotated. So when we rotate S2, it is clear that the wave vibration is not completely reached at B. So when the slit S2, which is highly perpendicular, exactly perpendicular to the slit S1, what will happen? There is no vibration is occurring beyond S2. That means why it is not reaching S2? Why these vibrations are not passing beyond S2 when S2 is perpendicular? This is the property of the wave that it acquired after passing through the slit S1. That is, when the vibrations which passes through the slit S1, what will happen? The vibrations only is occur along a particular line. That is, the waves get polarized. That's why when the slit is perpendicular to the vibration, we will not get any output from this. So this is a particular mechanical experiment to prove the polarization. Now we consider an optical experiment to prove the polarization. Here we need a tourmaline crystal. That the tourmaline crystal is in such a manner that whose faces are parallel to the crystallographic axis. Okay. When an unpolarized light which is allowed to fall on the tourmaline crystal, and then it will emerges out from the tourmaline other face of the tourmaline crystal. When we examine the emergent beam, we can see that the intensity of the light is okay and it will get slightly colored due to the color of the crystal. And when we rotate the tourmaline crystal, we observe that there is no change in the intensity. Okay. Now we again put another tourmaline crystal, okay, whose crystallographic axes are parallel to the faces. And we observe the emergent light from the tourmaline crystal. We can see that the intensity is the same and there is no variation in the intensity. When the second tourmaline crystal is rotated with respect to the first tourmaline crystal, we can see that there is a variation in the intensity. And at a particular angle, that is say 90 degree, we can see that there is no intensities occurring or no intensities emerging from the second tourmaline crystal. That is, the light emerging from the first tourmaline crystal is plane polarized. That's why when we rotate the second crystal, we didn't get the light because the vibrations only perpendicular to the crystallographic axis are getting from second tourmaline crystal. This is the optical experiment to prove the polarization. So the first tourmaline crystal, which is known as the polarizer, that is, it convert unpolarized light into a polarized light. It's known as polarizer. And the second crystal, which is known as analyzer. Okay. Now we are going to familiarize with the two terms, the plane of polarization and the plane of vibration. Okay, the plane of vibration, that means the plane containing or the plane parallel to the vibration of the particles. Okay, the plane of polarization means the plane perpendicular to the vibration of the particle. Okay, now let us consider how can we produce this polarized light. So there are different methods to produce polarized light, like polarization by reflection, polarization by refraction. First, we consider the polarization by reflection. That means when an unpolarized light is allowed to fall on a transparent material like glasses or water, what will happen? We know that it will get reflected and part of it will get refracted. Okay. When we examine the reflected light, we can see that it is partially polarized. Okay, now we change the angle of incidence and we can see that the degree of partial polarization get increases. At a particular angle, we can see that the light is completely plane polarized. And this angle, which is known as angle of polarization. Okay, so David Brewster, he developed a law based on this. According to his law, the tangent of the angle of polarization, that should be equal to the refractive index of the medium. So if we know the refractive index of the medium, we will obtain what? The angle of polarization. For example, we know that for glass, the refractive index is about 1.5. And from this, we can obtain that the angle of polarization is about 57.5 degrees. That means by falling an unpolarized light at an angle about 57.5 degree, we obtain the reflected light is completely plane polarized. Okay. Likewise, we can also obtain the plane polarized light by refraction. Okay. We know that when a light allowed to fall on a transparent material, it will get reflected. Part of light will get reflected. That means only a slight percentage is get reflected and we are obtaining the plane polarized light is very, the intensity of the plane polarized light is very small. So in order to get a high intensity light, we use the method of refraction. The method of refraction, which is consisting of almost 15 to 20 glass plates, which are arranged at a particular pattern in a tube. So particular pattern means the glass plates are arranged at an angle 32.5 degree with the axis of the tube, which is shown in the PPT. Okay, when the light is allowed to fall on the light, means unpolarized light is allowed to fall on the glass plate, it will get reflected and part of it will get transmitted. And we can understand that the light get reflected from each glass plate and we'll obtain a strong or highly intense polarized light. Okay, and when we examine also the transmitted light, we can see that the transmitted light is also plane polarized. Okay, thus we can produce plane polarized light by reflection and also by refraction. Now to get a highly intense light, intense polarized light, we adopt the method of refraction. Now we consider this experimental setup, that is the glass plate with a tube, is known as pile of plates. Okay. Now what are the different type of polarization? We already seen a plane polarized light. The other type of polarization, which are circularly polarized light, elliptically polarized light. What is meant by plane polarized light? We all know that it's a plane electromagnetic wave, that is in the plane of vibration, which is known as plane polarized light. How can we produce this plane polarized light? The plane polarized light can be produced by refraction or reflection. Okay, now the circularly polarized light. What do you mean by circularly polarized light? Okay, circularly polarized light, which is composed of two electromagnetic radiation, whose amplitude is equal and they differ by a phase of about 90 degree. Or in other words, two mutually perpendicular electromagnetic waves composes what? Circularly polarized light. Okay. Now the elliptically polarized light. The elliptically polarized light, it can be composed of two electromagnetic radiations whose amplitude are different. They differ by a phase difference again, 90 degree. Okay. Now, how can we produce this
circularly polarized and elliptically polarized light. For that, for production of circularly polarized light, we need two electromagnetic radiation of same amplitude, which are orthogonal to each other. And when these two electromagnetic radiation, which is allowed to fall on a Nicol prism, it will produce a plane polarized light. Okay? When this plane polarized light allowed to pass through a quarter wave plate, okay, when this plane polarized light allowed to pass through a quarter wave plate, we obtain a circularly polarized light. One condition, when this plane polarized light is allowed to fall on the quarter wave plate at particular angle, say 45 degree. The angle is kept at constant, 45 degree, we obtain a circularly polarized light. Okay. For production of elliptically polarized light, again we use two electromagnetic radiations of unequal amplitude, they are orthonormal to each other, and when allowed to these two unequal amplitude electromagnetic radiations are passes through a Nicol prism, it will produce a plane polarized light, and this plane polarized light is allowed to fall on a quarter wave plate, and we obtain an elliptically polarized light. Okay, again here are some condition. This, when the rays, plane polarized light is allowed to fall on the quarter wave plate at particular angles other than 0, 45 and 90 degree. Then we obtain elliptically polarized light. Okay, that's all about the polarization, and thank you for listening.